Okay, now we're going to find BC, given quadrilateral ABCD is congruent to quadrilateral WXYZ. Now, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to mark the vertices that correspond so I can understand the transformation. So A maps to W. And B matches to X. So B, then X. And C matches to Y, and D matches to Z. Okay, now this is going to be helpful. I need to know whether this is a translation or a rotation type deal, or how these points are oriented with each other. Now it looks to me that this is a rotation around this way. So this A goes with a W and the B goes with the X and so on and so forth. So what that means is this BC is going to match with the XY. Now at first glance I might have just matched the BC with the XW and then done that because, well, it looks like you could just scoot right across here, but I took the time to match the vertices correctly, and then I can see that BC actually matches with XY. So now that I have that information, I can write the correct equation and then finish out answering the question. So because this is a congruence, the corresponding parts of the congruent figures are congruent, so I can say 3x minus 4 equals x plus 10. Those are the measurements of segments BC and XY. So now I just need to solve. I'm going to subtract x from both sides first. That's going to give me 2x minus 4 equals 10, then add 4. 2x equals 14. Then divide by 2, and x equals 14 divided by 2, which is 7. Okay, now the question is asking to find BC. Now 7 isn't BC, 7 is the unknown variable x. But BC is 3x minus 4. So I'm going to apply that 7 and substitute for x. So it's 3 times 7 minus 4, and then I can just simplify. BC, 3 times 7 is 21, then minus 4. So BC is 21 minus 4, which is 17. All right, so let's review the process. First, I marked the coordinates and figured out what type of transformation made the congruence. So then I could go ahead and map this BC to XY correctly, and then I could write my equation. Because corresponding parts of congruent figures are congruent, then I solved for X, and then applied by substituting X back into the BC, 3X minus 4. Got my measurement of 17.